Hello everyone, welcome back to Squidderbox. Today we'll be taking a look at this 112th collection Deluxe version of Enveloped Yaomo by Nauta Collections. So the story tells that three exorcists with different personalities went on their way of destroying Yaomo, leading by Taoism Yan Chixia, Nura the Ronin, and Wukong the Monkey. Pre-order starts over a year ago, and I'm happy to announce that they've done a really great job this time. And if you're buying an English version, you get the English version comic, and they've actually made a Chinese poem for each character. And it also comes along with this nice instructions, which also has English version, and if you turn to the back of it, you will see their different stories in Mandarin and English version. And wow, take a look at those packs of accessories. I mean, this is how you tell a good story using toys. We'll take a closer look at them one by one later on and see how their stories unfold. It all started when about a year ago, before the pre-order started, and Nauta Collection come to me and said that we could work out about the whole stories and how the characters went on. And if you're familiar with those Hong Kong movies back in the 80s, you will see that this unfolds exactly as one of those Knight Errant films. They got those beliefs and they got their own tangled emotions, they are suffering about life and death of all those stuffs. It brought me back to the good old days when there are still new swordsman movies coming up. Alright, without further ado, let's see how it does. So first things first, let's take a look at the Taoism Yan Chixia. So this is the standard version, as you can see, he got the sword, he got those knightly scarf, and he was on his way to find his master when he got involved with all those fights. You get to see that later in the comics. But it gets really interesting when it comes to the Deluxe version. I mean, take a look at all those accessories, and if you have paid attention to the Mandarin version using Google Translate, you'll see that it has different backgrounds which actually shows different sides of his personality. Now, my favorite part of this character is his talisman. You get to see that as a Taoism, he got all those gadgets and different skills to use. And he hates all the Yao so much that when he finds out Wukong was actually one of them, he bursts out Forge Me Fire and turn into the Deathblow mode. I'll have to say the clothes are really well tailored, exactly as the way it is in the comics. And if you got the Deluxe version, you'll be surprised of how much accessories they've got. They got those special FX swords, they got an ordinary sword, they got a bamboo hat for the rain, they got all those talismans and the beautiful head sculpt and different poster hands. Let's start from the talisman. They use pad painting to make sure that all the talismans look clearly enough and it won't go off even if you rub it with your hands. And except for that, they've got those flaming effects talisman. And you can see how well performed those flaming effects are. So glittery and translucent. And you know, back in the ancient times, they were using gourd as flagons. And now, you're seeing one of them. And you can see that there are embossments on its both sides. And in the front, it's written the word Jiu, which means wine in Mandarin. And in the back of it is the Chinese dragon. And what's coming next is one of my favorites. Look at that. The shooting flaming talisman. You can attach it to one of those poster hands and point it to the bad guys on the other. It just looks so crystal under the light. And I know what you've been waiting for, let's take a closer look at the special FX sword. It is so delicately made and you can even see the Taoism symbols and figures in the sword. And look at that gradient. But there's one thing that I would suggest you to pay special attention to. Be careful not to bend off the pointing. Next, there is those flaming sword when you're waving them. You can see the Taoism symbols are even more delicate and clear in this one. And if any of you understand what it means, please leave it in the comment. And as you can see, the flaming effect sets steadily on the handle. Now moving on to the actual sword. You can see that it's really well painted and all those details are attached to it firmly. Gives me a feeling that Yan has been carrying this sword all the way down to where the Yao has been located. And do mind that once you pull it out, you will see that the blade is actually made of metal. I mean, take a look at it. You could see how it reflects the bluish light, and you could even feel how sharp it is. And it will fit perfectly and steady in its scabbard. Just like that. And as a Taoism, he got a trigram mirror, and the inscription on it represents different elements in the Taoism culture. They stand for the sky and ground, the thunder and wind, the fire and water, and mountain and forest. And Yan always carries the jade his master gives him to protect himself from the evil spirits. And the knot on it was a traditional Chinese knot, which represents happiness and prosperity. Now let's move on to something that you can see in almost every sword in the movie, a straw ring cape. You know, that's how they keep themselves and their weapons dry and away from all those pouring rains. You can see all those stains and patches that was painted on it. Now we have this cloth scarf that you can easily attach on the head sculpt. This is how they prevent all those sand and dust from coming into their eyes and mouth when they're riding horses. Now we have this special FX head sculpt when Yan bursts out, "Forge me fire." You can see the way that all those fire just coming out from his body and swerving to the sky. And if any of you have ever bought their previous product, you will see that they use exactly the same kind of material as they made in the Captain Marvel's head sculpt pack. And yet this time, the whole head sculpt illuminates under the UV light. And furthermore, you can even see the shooting talisman special effects also have illuminating effects. And wait until you see how they've done with the swords. The whole FX sword just glowing under the UV light, and actually, the two of them have different effects. I think the Wailing Sword is actually looking way more brighter. Now, moving on to the next character, Wukong. As you can see, this is so much for the basic version. And you can see just how much accessories it comes along with the Deluxe version. It has all those different weapons and has special effects and explainers, so much things for it, and look at that head sculpt. Wow, that's really amazing. And we'll be taking a closer look at them one by one. Now, starting with the head sculpt. This one is when Yan finds out that Wukong was actually a Yao. Now here's a little bit background review just in case you don't understand what a Yao Mo is. As you can see the background story, anywhere that's rich in Riki, a Yao could be found. They're actually just ordinary animals using Riki to become immortal. And that procedure may take hundreds of years. Now moving on to those two monstrous fists as he transformed into a Yao. Now let's take a closer look, as you can see all those fur and the fists are highly detailed, and you can even see the stain in his fingernails. Just see how the way the fur moves with the fist as he gives out a punch. However, the joint here might give some side effect to the articulation, yet the overall holding stand is quite alright. You can easily see how massive this fist is compared with my own fist. Now moving on to the Zin Palm that Wukong has used in the comic as a special skill. As you can see, this is really crystal-like and transparent, and also it will glow under the UV lights just as other special effects accessories in the Deoxlu version. Now, unlike Yan, who is mastered in all those skills, Zinpeng was actually almost everything he knows how to use as a skill. Now, before introducing others, I'd like to show you those two tiny little planets that are also delicately made. Now, actually, in our early draft version of the background story, we were thinking to let those two bananas to become exactly the trigger of Wukong's transformation, but the outcome wasn't that well, so we just turned it down. Now, I'm thrilled to show you this special FX stick. As Wukong poured his Ricky into it, the whole stick glows with light. And don't get me wrong, if you put it under the UV light, the whole stick actually glows a yellowish blue light that looks almost like magic, really magnificent if you're looking with your own eyes. And also there's another stick that was bended with the tremendous force of Wukong as he waved the stick towards Yan in the comic. The painting and curve on it is really outstanding, and you could also attach the wind special effect on the stick. But do be careful with it though, you don't want to break it or something else like that happens. I know it looked pretty cool already, but wait until you see this. The whole thing just glowed under the UV light with the bluish light. Now, unlike Yan, who has got a nicely handmade scarf, what Wukong has here is almost like rags. And yet, it does have wires attached to it in the end, so you could easily bend it into any shape you like and it will hold firmly on its neck. Now, before we take a closer look at how this figure did, I would like to show you this particular accessory that is really interesting to me. This is the mask Wukong had stolen from his original circus, and the rubber band in its back can make sure that it will hold firmly on the head sculpt. Although this mask is made of plastic, you can see how great the silver and red and gold paint looked on it. Now, without further ado, let's see how this figure did. I must say that this is my personal favorite of the three. Now, you can see the head sculpt and his weapon. We will talk about them one by one. Now, this metal stick really has some great carves on it, and we'll take a closer look at it. You can see the dragon-like carves on each end, and the body is made of wood. So you can see all the delicately carved wooden grain on it. And the Buddha beast in front of his chest is actually separately made and stitched together by hand one by one. And he also made himself a tiny little skirt that was made out of a tiger skin. This is one of the best clothing designs I've ever seen on a 1/12 scale toy collection. Now, moving on to the last character, Nura from the Far Land. This is pretty much everything in the standard version. And as you can see, all those knives are really greatly made. We'll be taking a closer look at them one by one later on. And in the Deoxlu version, it has included even more accessories, just as you can see right now. He has all those different stitch ring capes and all these accessories and food. And look at all those special effects swords, we'll be talking about them one by one. But before that, let's take a closer look at this ring cape. You can see it is clearly different from Yan's, and this is even more delicately made and has more stain, which means he can wear it for a long time. The longer he wears it, the rougher it gets. And I must show you closeness to this ring cap. You could see the sword and knife curve on it, means that he has been wearing it into many of those battles that he has fought. And it also comes along with a brand new hairband. You could attach and switch on it. And the next accessory is the Yin Yang Jade that has been passed on from his Asian generations. As we have introduced in the background story, he is a half-blood human and Yao. So this might be the trigger to control his anger. And the weapon he had carried along with him is really magnificent. This blade is actually made of stainless steel, and you could see how they did with the blade. It is just unbelievable that they did this quenching mark on a 1/12 scale figure's blade, and it reflects bluish light under my camera. I'll really give you guys a closer focus on this. You could see how well they did with the whole blade that is actually even thinner than my fingertip. And the painting on the handle is really also marvelous. You could see the white paint and the bluish paint covered one another. And like most of the runners, he also has two swords, one longer for battles and one smaller for emergency uses only. And this one we could easily see that the wooden curve on the shelves really detailed. And even though this one was a little bit shorter, a little bit smaller, all those details are really stunning. I'm personally willing to bet that you could even cut paper with it. Look how sharp it is. And it fits perfectly still in the shell. Let's put it back before it hurts anyone. And some accessories that I found really interesting is those three rice buns. And you can see how delicately the details are painted and curved on it. This is how he used in the comic to stop those two from fighting one another to death. And one accessory that I found relatively funny is this little bottle of sake that it comes along with. You can just imagine how he managed to fight all those Yaomas after drunk. Or perhaps he's the only one sober on the battlefield, who knows? Now, as I said a moment ago, he's a half-blood, half Yao, half human. And now let's take a closer look at this magnificent head sculpt. This is one of the favorite head sculpts of the whole set of my personal. I know it already looked great with all those silver hairs and veins and fonts, but you have to see how it looked under the UV light. Let me show you, wait a second. Now, et voila, you could see that the whole head sculpt just burst out a glowish like and sense of frozen under the UV light. It just seemed that it's been really hard to deal with. Now we've seen the other two introducing their skills and death blows, and in the comics, I think this is the best death blow so far. And you can see how the icicles and icebergs are sticking out from his hand, but wait until you see how it glows under the UV light. The bluish light just came right out of it. You can see how magnificent this looks under the light. Really something of an ultimate death blow. And moving on, you can see the ice sword that he had made out of nothing. Literally out of nothing. And this ice sword also glows under the UV light. You can see that it's really frosty and ready to stab someone. A feeling of sub-zero only by looking at it. And apart from that, it also comes along with the blade of ice. I'll have to say that it is already satisfied to look at it when you hold it in your hands. Now, it also comes along with this tobacco pipe that at first sight I thought it was made of metal, but it is actually a plastic one with great metallic paint on it. And also, it comes along with a mask that was usually seen on the kabuki theater in the Japanese traditional culture. And you can see it has a semi-wooden, semi-metal kind of paint on it. Looked pretty scary when you hold it in hand, so you could see that it might be some badass who's wearing it. Now let's take a closer look at the clothes of his. I'll have to say that This is usually seen in the Japanese movies or TV series such as the Rurouni Kenshin. And the reason that he has a reddish shirt is to avoid, well, the blood paint. Now this is everything about the toy and our video. And remember to subscribe if you like it. There will be furthermore stories about enveloped 妖魔. Now, see you in our next video.